Hello and welcome back to In My Image. We won the war last time, but only barely, and only after losing every single soldier we had built. Yep, all of these are mercenaries. We're gonna use the mercenaries to take care of rebels and take back these provinces. But firstly, let's take a look at what we took. All of this striped stuff is gonna be fed into a client state, except for these, because I've already started coring them. They are part of areas that I want to hold personally, along with Mewat is also being cored. So what we're gonna do is create a little state here in Delhi, and I took a look at what name I would like for it. So all of these here are the Doabs. I presume it's a river. It's probably the river Doab here. So it's gonna be a little name I've readied in the copy-paste. Doabin Salbar, which basically means the realm of the Doab. And it's gonna be a monarchy of our dynasty. And what color do we want for it? Not orange, at least. Wrap some blue. It's gonna turn off the fan real quickly, in case it interferes. Maybe cobalt or that blue. Maybe this I kind of like this blue, actually. So we're definitely not having a Muslim crescent. What should we have? A horse, maybe. Let's randomize it, see if we get something nice as a random flag. Fish. A polar bear is not exactly what we're looking for here. More fishes, more angels and Christian symbols. Pig. This random thing is not that good, to be honest. I'll random it until I get a few colors I like, at least. Well, I kind of like the background here, but not the emblem. So let's take a look at what emblems we could put on here. Let's go with... maybe this horse? Well, a horse feels too old Mongol. I mean, this one looks good. It's a bit strange, though, with the pattern in the background. Maybe another background? Maybe this? And maybe another color? Oh, flag color 3 isn't even used. I like that one. Maybe a yellow. Or a red? A red might be nice. You know what? Let's go with this. It's not super pretty, but it's not ugly either. Actually, let's just make sure that there aren't any nicer reds. No. Maybe we should have white here, and then blue. Alright, let's go with this one. This is... actually, that's not blue, that's turquoise. This is blue. Let's go with this. Okay. And this client state is gonna start off hating me, which is a bit interesting. In any case, let's feed it some land. Let's give it central Doab. This is gonna take a little while, but it's gonna be worth it. Give it all to you. And they're gonna have to core all of this land, which is a bit unfortunate, but it also means that they don't really have time to rise up against me. I'm gonna have my mercenaries take care of any rebels that rise up in this area. We're gonna give it everything. This is harking back to the CK2 era when I gave out a lot of provinces, only I don't have to do this more than once, fortunately. And this hopefully is going to be a fairly powerful client state. I'm unsure if you can make client states into marches, but I will make it into a march if I can. It's got really good ideas. I buffed the client state idea slightly to be on par with the rest of the ideas in the world, like I did with the colonial ideas. They are more violent, less nice. So now we have the Doabin Salbar. Unfortunately, this province should really belong to them, but it's Kalpis, and there's not much I can do about that. We're not gonna pay back our loans, we're gonna build an army to satisfy our vassals, because if you take a look at our vassals right now, they are quite liberty because of the fact that our armies are super weak. So let's placate local rulers, we don't need the prestige right now, and unpause and see what happens. Oh, and we're also not gonna pay for our ships right now. No, we need all the money we can get. Actually, let's a little bit of fleet maintenance. Advancement of the nobility has ended. Let's go with marriage with Kalpi. And they are coring Garwal so far. Did they get a good ruler? Yeah. Right, so Adam Bayad is probably not a good name. It's probably, it doesn't find the name from the list for some reason and goes with Adam. But I believe they will find the names in the following successions, hopefully. So it's Inan Mongol, because we created it here. It does control some non-Inan territory, but it should be fine. Should be able to accept those. Maybe I should have created it here just to make them accept it. But then again, it doesn't really matter. They will do well in any case. We just need to make sure that they don't die from rebels. That's all we need to do. We're getting our manpower back fast. And we need it fast, to be honest. We need it now. Yeah, they handle it automatically. That's good. Sure, Yesage, don't give me any tribute. Whatever. It's fine, though, when I build more units, you're gonna want to give it to me again. Do I want this? Number of states, administrative efficiency, development efficiency. Development efficiency. Sounds delicious. But no, not yet. And we have plenty of admin. Let's go with that. We should have leaders. Plenty of leaders. This one is the best. Go and kill it. Kill the peasants. Nice. Another 20 stack up and running. Let's get another one. Like, we need to get troops up and running, because who knows when we're gonna need them. There we go. We're gonna have to take care of them. Go and kill them. Nice. Very good, very good. And another ability. And we're gonna go for Liberty Desire in Same Continent Subjects, I do believe. Though this one is not bad. Liberty Desire from Subjects Development. Should we go with Improved Artillery Damage, though? I mean, I have a feeling that Mengi Temuria might want to take revenge. No, actually, let's take Loyal Subjects. We want Loyal Subjects. We're the Mongol Emperor. Of course we have Loyal Subjects. You go here. Can even use the boots. We have loans to pay back as well. It's unfortunate, but... Oh, right. More land force limit modifier. Perfect. Exactly what we needed. Actually, let's send in the mercenaries. Oh, we can create some states. Alright, so you can go to Bayadia, hang out in Bayadia. You are the mercenaries, right? Yep. Consolidate your regiment, because you're only mercenaries. We don't have to pay that much for you. And the coring is going well here. The coring is extra cheap because of the ideas. The ideas look like this, by the way. Super powerful. 25% core creation cost. And they already got a bunch of idea sets filled out. Administrative, quantity, defensive, humanist, quality, economic, and trade. And they are in Mongol. And they are Tengeli God. And they have an enlightened despotism. Interesting. Autonomy change, promoted cultures, etc, etc. Number of states and cooldown, stuff like that. Can I make them a march? No, I don't. Well, maybe it's a. Yeah, designate march. A march doesn't pay any taxes to their overlord, and the overlord can't annex them. Yeah. Let's do that. And also, we're earning money quickly. We need to get our army back up, and it needs to be back up very soon. More manpower! More! And we get any... Nah, it's not worth it. Let's repay the loan. We have another loan coming up in 3 years. We can pay it off as soon as we get the money, really. Let's merge up the fleet. The Valetenhorde is expanding. Oh, by the way, this is still their vassal, Ambagai. They have not annexed them yet, though. That's interesting. And Odogor Ulsin. I thought they would die for sure, but they are taking over Britain. And who else is taking over Britain but Usunia? What are you doing in Ireland? Get out of there. You're not supposed to be there. Varanasi. You're taking care of it. Good, good. Nice. Let's merge. Consolidate the regiments. It's only mercenaries. Consolidating. It's good for us. Wait, are you fighting... You're fighting Karkotan. Alright, so you're only fighting Karkotan and Cisney. Well, good on you, Guglug. How is the great power looking? Ah, oh, we're ahead. We beat down Mengu Temuria. And we have the number one top spot in the world. How does that look for... How does it look for Mengu Temuria, by the way? Armies. 132 mercenaries? You're gonna go bankrupt, aren't you? I mean, 300,000. Are you fighting someone? Yeah, you are. You're... nationalist warring... Ebedegedjin. Your former ally. Someone else is slowly but surely reaching the levels of Mengu Temurian army, and that's Audaghost. And Audaghost is still way behind in military tech. Why aren't you teching up? You really need to. You had 17. Only 17. Development, admin, number of states. Not really needed. There was something interesting here. We can divert... I didn't see this one before. Send officers. We want to send officers, definitely, because it increases their morale and discipline by a whole lot. We also subsidize their armies. That doesn't actually do anything, though. So now we're doing that in both of them. It works out. Yeah, sending officers. We can also subsidize their armies, of course, but I'm not sure if... I mean, we need the money right now. Let's pay off. Let's pay off the loan. And soon we can start building a few more armies. Let's do that. Oh, are you already... Are you already done? No, Guglug is... is attacking, but they haven't occupied anything. Or maybe they lost a few battles or something. Oh, and Japan is opportunistic and also attacking. No, they are helping Guglug. I see what's going on here. Don't forget that your target is over here. Traitor. Guglug the traitor. Modern bureaucracy, I guess we're going for it. Public punishments. Wanna go for that? No, we don't have to yet. Can load up way more power. Yeah, Doab in Salbar, led by Chief Adam Bayad. Adam. Nice. Nice name. And we can finish off Esprit de Corps and get to recover morale speed. Well, it's not bad. Can we get some interesting policy now? Leader siege, siege ability, artillery combat ability. That's not bad. Horse artillery. Ah, nice. That suits us just fine. Strapping artillery to our horses. There we go. We want more. More, more, more. Let's start with that. We recovered quicker than I expected. I wonder if anyone is gonna be revolutionized. You're annexing Archai. Ah, nice. Mingitamuria is growing, even though they just lost a bunch of land. No. Right, our royal marriage has ended. Do you want to get another? My allies are traitors. I've helped them so much and they do not help me because they like Mingitamuria. What bullshit is that? How can they like someone who's been my rival for ages? Right, we need more troops. More. We can also get rid of the mercenaries now. We don't need them anymore. Give us a bit more money. Yeah. Now we're up to what? 200 out of 400. 400? Oh, it must be a contribution from them. How much have you managed to core? Not all of it. You're coring along. You're coring this one. And it's also Norse. I guess you're gonna syncretize with Norse. I mean, your entire nation is Norse, pretty much. We have already syncretized with our Norse. We get a bit of unrest, sure, but not that much. And we can also bump up our absolutism a little bit. We're decreasing autonomy. Where can we decrease autonomy? Let me decrease. I guess I can't. Curses. Alright, more armies. More. We need so many. We need to have the biggest army in the world. We're probably not going to beat Mingitamuria, but we might. I mean, they seem to be more interested in going to war than healing their economy. Alright, you go there and take care of them. Or are you? Maybe you're not. No, you are. Oh, thank you, Kalpi. Brilliant. Right, now we're capped on dip, so better invest. Let's invest. Agitate for liberty. What does that even mean? Agitate for liberty. You're Mingitamuria spy network. Yeah, maybe we should build a spy network in Mingitamuria to see what they are up to. There they annexed Archai. Wow. What are you gonna do next, Mengu? By the way, did you, no, we're tied now. We're about as powerful. About as powerful. Where did we have gold, by the way? I'm gonna take a look at our gold. There we have gold. Bump up the production. We need more money. Haha, 18. Oh, we have even more here. Let's do this. How much gold do we get now? 22. Ah, well, it's got a chance of depleting, but that's all right. If it depletes, it depletes. 20 army. Let's go there and there, along with here and... Oh, now we're out of manpower again. Well, the glorious Bayad army is up to speed. Duab in Salba. We need to influence them, by the way. We are not influencing them. We really should be. I don't think we're influencing Talpi either. There we go. We need to influence you. That's expensive, but it has to be worth it, I guess. Especially if... Okay, they're gonna get Diplo. So, are you actually coring anything here? Oh, what happened? So this is 5, 6, 7, 8 stats. 8 again, and this is 9. So let's go with the Gregarious side. Cthulhu XXI Bayad. The 21st. but not Belgute. Let's go with Nogai. Oh, it's because they haven't actually made any states yet, because they have not cored everything in every state. Alright, bad for them, but... eventually they will get everything together, I suppose. Regana and... Duabin Sal. Build some more troops. Few more 20 armies. Can't go wrong with some 20 armies. Oh, Shiragulia has taken Karkapua back. I'm not sure if I noticed that. Probably didn't. Have you taken a lot of land, Valaten? You have taken more land, and especially you fed your vassal, and now you're annexing them. Gonna be done in. yeah, like 30 years. Oh, Choctaw has taken a heavy toll on Texas. Look at that. Yeah, the North Americans are taking what is rightfully theirs. Inca, on the other hand, has lost a few. Peruvian coast. Not enough to make a colonial nation, though. Are you really converting these? No, you're settling them. This you have not taken. Yeah, you've taken this. You've taken Lima. Not sure how well Inca is gonna do actually. 15 military tech. Not gonna be good for you. No, not gonna convert anything. That's not what I do. I don't convert. I harmonize. That's what I do. You have humanism ideas, so even though you haven't harmonized yet, it's not going to be a problem for you. Targana. You're going to claim the throne of Targana? Nah. 20 army. We need more. Fortunately, we have one hell of a manpower regain rate. 5,000, about 5,000 every month. Yeah, it's not bad. It's more than decent. Have you won your war yet, Mengu? Yes, you have. Well, they don't waste any time, do they? Now they only have territorial cores. So they must have taken their last era thing. This one, Char Mongol States, where they get 20 states. Wonder how many states we have out of the ones we can. Well, we can have 51 states. We're not even close to it. We could own half the world. What would be fun about owning half the world? Yeah. Did you lose territory, Guglug? No, you gained territory, but not much. Gained two provinces or something. Yeah, we have the largest army now. Mengu Temuria, not even close. Not even... Well, they've at least gotten rid of all their mercenaries now. They had so many mercenaries before. Guglug and Audaghost have lots of mercenaries as well. Are you losing a war, Audaghost? You must have... You must have lost a war. Surely. Maybe. Yeah, against Delki. I guess. Delki is a surprisingly powerful nation. Now we're taking improved artillery from back row. Why not one more 20 army? Why not? Now we can start funding our boats again. Fleet maintenance. We have an incredibly powerful economy. Maybe we should build some buildings. Just maybe. Universities, maybe? I don't know. Let's build some stock exchanges. There we go. That's not bad. Build all of them. Oh, Lahore. Yeah, we have a stack going up there to kill them. They had time to take it, curses. We couldn't be prouder. Oh, a gentleman and an offer. No, sweet. This must be an event based on the fact that we're sending officers to Doabin and Kalpi. What are you doing, Korchia? You haven't, well... You're trying to imperialize Totonac. How is that going for you? I'm not sure, mostly well. Texas revolutionaries. Revolutionary Texas. Oh, when I turned off the continent requirement for revolutions, I didn't actually think about that, but yeah, the revolution can occur in... Can occur in America now. That's gonna be really stupid, though. I hope that doesn't happen. Or if it happens, it needs to be a Native American. Like Cherokee or Choctaw. Stop building spy networks! Can we do something interesting with the spy network we have? I'm not sure. Let's go own subject and threatening. Guglug is threatening, apparently. Are you someone's tributary state? No. So Volatinhood is annexing Ambagai, and Ambagai does... No, they used to have... Is Canada free? No, Canada is a colony of the Volatinhood, right. So Volatinhood has a few colonial nations, New-Calais and Canada. New-Calais, alright, New-Calais is being destroyed. Yeah, they're being... annexed by Korchia, or maybe not, because what is Korchia gonna do? Brazil is not theirs, is it? No, it's Chiragulia's. Do I really want to go for the Cuirassier? I don't think so. bump some development. There we go. Lots of money. Let's go with that. Any wars going on at all? I think the Valetan Horde are attacking Korchia. Reconquest of Sirmia. Oh. This is Sirmia. Well, good luck, Valetan Horde. I'm not sponsoring you anymore, you know? So you can't do whatever you like. You can only do pretty much whatever you like. Our generals are dying of old age. Shame. Did you actually take anything, Japan? No, you didn't get anything. Only Guglug got anything. Guglug are so greedy. Well, we need to build more. Now we need to invest in greed. Oh, almost. Almost. Very close for us to be able to build all of it. Stock exchanges. We're gonna be the new Wall Street. A stock exchange wherever you turn your gaze. Oh, Mengu. You're attacking Inalchi in an imperialist war. You're gonna surpass me again? You've already surpassed me again. Oh, Mengu. I would be lying if I wasn't impressed. Where are you gonna win, though? We have the biggest army, but Mengu Temuri has the second biggest army. I'm kind of impressed with our army, to be perfectly honest. Bigger than I expected it to be. Can I even... I can stack them 2 and 2, I think. It's gonna be way nicer. 41. Let's stack them together a bit randomly and see if anyone takes attrition. It's nicer than having all of these random 20k stacks standing around. Well, this one cannot be there, so you go here. No, actually, you're there. Truce is up with Mengu Temuria. That's fun. Is this a very non-developed province or something? Yeah, it might be. All of them merged up. I mean, 40k is the least we could ask for in this day and age. Oh, we're capped on power. I didn't even notice. I'm sorry. Do this. Develop them until they can't be developed anymore. Spices and wool. There we go. Might as well pump some manpower into it as well. There we go. So Koshin, it's one of those down here, yeah. I invested a lot into this province. I should develop Kutch. Really. Could use a bit of development. Anyway, this went better than expected. We're fully staffed up with men and ready to go. The year is 1749. Have we got the last institution yet? Yes, we have. There's no more institutions to be had, so 1750. Oh, wait, what's going on here? Oh, Mengu Temuri is fighting on two fronts. Tsusni and Alkmaarid. So Tsusni is pushing in from the east. This used to be their old ally. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.